Hello everyone, welcome back to the workshop. This is the 4th of July week. This video should be coming out, if everything goes well with the build, the day before the 4th of July. And I thought, why not highlight two kits made in the USA for July 4th, this cool week. We're going to be building up two kits, and then I'm going to be painting and customizing one of the kits. We're going to be able to see them both on the show. We'll unbox them. I will assemble them. Then I will be painting the cave bear and detailing it, and we'll let you see the saber-toothed tiger. It'll be assembled and possibly painted and detailed at another time as more of these kits come out. So these are 1/13th scale kits from Atlantis Toy and Hobby. They sent these over for full reviews. These, of course, are reissues of older kits that they purchased the models, the molds from, and they are releasing them. I assume if they have them all, eventually they will release the entire set. They kind of build into this prehistoric scene setup with a circle of bases at interlock and all the animals and stuff like that. What we've got on the desk are the saber-toothed tiger and the cave bear, and they've got some interesting details in each one. First up, we will take a look at the 1/13th scale cave bear. They got the vintage packaging. They just changed their name on there, and it is really neat. There's a what I call a paint guide on the back if you want to paint it up like the person who built it for Atlantis. It's got its base, it's got a little nameplate and all that. Let's take a look at the cool parts in the kit. One thing I like about this one is, being a figure kit, it has been pre-molded in black, so you could actually assemble it. It would be a black bear, not a big problem and all that. We've got the nice nameplate here, cave bear, 80,000 years ago, late Pleistocene time in Europe. We've got the bear, we got jaws, and stuff for the debris around the field. We've got his big, look at his big cushy feet. Look at his big foot pads. We've got his interior mouth. So that's interesting. They even have all that detail on there. Look at the cute little ears. How can bears be so dangerous when they've got little puffy ears like that? I don't get it. They'll eat you alive. But they got adorable faces. There's his adorable little face. He's not so happy in this one. They had to make him look aggressive back in the day. And in real life, they will eat you. We got more of the body parts with the hair texture on there. So this is going to involve painting and a lot of dry brushing to bring out detail. We've got his little paws with his claws here. Check out the detail on that. So yeah, there's not a ton of kits still made in the USA. You've got Salvino's JR for the stock car kits. And we've got Atlantis for pretty much everything else. And there's very few that are molded in the USA anymore. Some of Round 2's kits and some of Revell USA kits will be molded in the US, but not a ton of them. We can check out the pads of the paw, more of his arms. Arms or legs, hard to tell. This thing is really cool. So these parts here, when I pick them up, you put them in, it looks like a big gerbil, doesn't it? Like that could be his eyes, and this is like a mole. So that's pretty cool. That's the size of him. That's the body of the bear. The box says no glue needed, so we'll see how well they press together. We may want to run beads of glue down some seams, and I'm not going to do a lot of any seam work on this kit. I build them as they come out of the box. If it's a huge gap, I will fill it in. But we know my builds. I don't like to do stuff like that. I want to build it out of the box and let you decide if you want to buy the kit. So we see all the interlocking areas for the arms and the legs. And then the parts that I have the most fun with figure kits are these parts right here. The bases. So we've got the fire pit base, obviously prehistoric. There would have been Neanderthals and other type of pre-humans, pre-Homo sapiens walking around. So, and some Homo sapiens, but anyways, where this is supposed to be, we've got a little fire ring. Obviously man-made. We've got the other flat of the base. They will interlock. These are all for interlocking into other of the prehistoric bases. And these will go together. There's a way I have to line these up the right way. But these will go together. And then the wall goes over or around one of the two. Something like that. There's holes in here for it. So it goes around the backside or something like that. There's all different kinds of cool pieces. When I start assembling, we'll see how they go together. But this is a rock wall, holes in it and everything, so we'll be able to paint that, dry brush it. I love doing that stuff with craft paints. Gets my hands absolutely filthy. So we're gonna have all the base materials to work with and enjoy. That is everything that will be in the Cave Bear kit. If you think it's hard to assemble these kits, the assembly isn't the difficulty. These are the nice photo instructions. They give you some history of the Cave Bear, which is always fun. And then we go into the super easy press fit assembly stage. And they've got a paint guide if you like following that. So, but it should go together quite well inside of the mouth. And then the base, they show you how to interlock it and get it all set up. I'm gonna start gluing mine together and I'll be back in just a moment. Next up is the sweet saber-toothed tiger. He's got a big lisp because he's got those giant teeth on there. Also on 1/13 scale, all the prehistoric scenes will be in the same scale so that they can interlock together. This one, just like the bear, has movable rear and front legs. It's got a tree base. It's got the nameplate. And it's even got an animal leg in this one, an antelope leg. So this one I will be gluing together. I won't be painting and detailing it at this time. I just don't have the time to do two kits at a time most of the days, but we will take a look at all the cool parts. This one is molded in orange, which gives you that orangey kitty look. So we've got our rock base, we've got some bones here molded in, and these should push up against all the other ones, all the other bases in the series. Here we've got more of the base. We got two large base pieces. We got some leaves on the ground. You can see it's a lot of detail on there. That orange is quite garish, so that really stands out. Then we've got, what do we got over here? We got the body of the kitty with his big old teeth coming down and his part tongue. So this one, the mouth is molded together in the kit. And then that will go together. You have a nice looking kitty. So that should come together nicely. And we'll see how it all goes together once we're doing the overhead view of the assembly. Then we've got the legs and the paws with the claws on them. And these are movable. That's why they lock in with that cam design. So when you're going to paint these, make sure you paint them fully so when you move it, you don't have the plastic showing underneath. If you want to move it, my stuff I usually glue into one pose and leave, because I'm more worried about stuff falling apart. We've got his big soft paws with his little toe beans. You know, if you see a saber-toothed tiger, just go up and pet it. That's all they want. They just want to get hugged. Just run as fast as you can towards it and give it a big hug. Same with any like lion or cougar in the woods. Just if you see them, just get out there, run, put your arms up, run as fast as you can until just get a big embrace. So there we go. There's so many legs and arms. Looks like I've got doubles of everything, but I'm sure I've got just what I need. So we've got this older molds. We're going to have some flash. This just tears off, and then we clean that up with a knife. It's not a big deal. And these kits are older than I am, so it's not a surprise. We got the other legs on here. Do I have like 47 legs? I'm not sure. We got the antelope leg, which is cool, with its hoof. And it's got the thing to be pushed into the base. That's cool. Bones sticking out with the socket. Ew. Kids love that back in the day. It's so goofy. We got the tree for the base. Nice to see that. Looks like a cool little bonsai tree. So Mr. Miyagi was alive back then. And he was obviously shaping trees and making them look super cool. He's like, I reckon broccoli. And then he made his tree look like broccoli. So that's awesome. And then the name tag on this one. Saber-tooth tiger. Pleistocene time, 100,000 years ago, knife-like canine teeth, 9 inches long. Little factoids on there. I love that stuff. The instructions for this one are just as simple. Gives you a nice history of the saber-toothed tiger. Then we get into the simple build process, pushing everything together, making sure, telling you, you can make sure the legs and everything still move if you want to pose your model. A full paint guide on the inside. And those all sets of legs on there. And the cave bear on the back, which is the one we're going to be painting in this video. So I will get to working on that stuff. We'll start assembling everything, and I'll see you soon. Thank you. At this point, both of the kits have been assembled, and I'm ready to step into the painting phase. We've got the saber-toothed tiger. Why did I think I had double the amount of legs? Because I do. I wasn't paying much attention. But I've got an entire extra set of legs to change the pose of the saber-toothed tiger. He can be leaping, he can be swiping. It depends on how you want to pose the cat. I've got him leaping over the little tree, which is attached to the base. He's guarding his antelope leg. He's like, dude, I'm having dinner. Why are you trying to sell me an extended warranty on my car? I want nothing to do with this. I don't even know what a car is. They won't be invented for 100,000 years. So he is all upset. He's angry. He's lunging and swiping the same way we do at people that come to sell us things. And we've got the cool base here. You can arrange the base off to the side. We've got the tree installed. Check out the little kitty. Cleaned him up a little bit, glued it together. You can see how nicely that head looks once you clean the flash off the top and around the teeth and all that. Sharpen up those teeth. He looks pretty tough. And he's like, yo, either that or he's saying high five to a friend. He's like, yo, what up? I haven't seen you in forever. So anyways, you got to play with your stuff a little bit. You got to have fun. So we've got all the different legs there. They just interlock onto the body. So you can change the poses. You can change whatever he's doing. We've got the base here. The tree is just lightly pressed into place. It locks into the base down there. And then the antelope leg. And I'm almost thinking about saving this leg and using it in the bear diorama. Since I'm going to be painting the bear. I don't know, because, I mean, bear's got to eat too. So we are all set there, and he can be posed any way you want. Right there, I kind of got him leaping over that. You can change out all the different legs, get those glued on or simply snapped on if you want to work it like that. Then we move on to the cave bear, which will be getting the full paint and detail treatment. Got the nameplate separately so that we can paint that. We've got Mr. Bear here. Now his stuff can be moved as well. All of his legs, whoop, I popped it right out. All of the legs and stuff can be moved. I've got him glued together to hide most of the seams. The head can be turned if you desire. I like the pose, you know, kind of like so. He'll be attached to the base. He'll be like, rawr, you know, coming at you. The head and face detail on the bear is super cool. We'll try to bring the light down a little more here. I really like that. That is really great detail, especially for a kit 1972. Clamp the nose, which closed the seam across the head. And then we just place glue on there. That's why it's a lighter color. But I'm not going to do any sanding or rescribing of hair or anything like that. But everything still moves if you wanted it to move, or if you wanted it to be still, whatever you desire. It's a good looking bear. Nice size to it, should be easy to work on. Then we've got our base. This base glues together. There is no interlocking on the saber-toothed tiger. I've got the two skulls. One, I left the jaw separate from the top of the skull, so we can pose that in the scene. And then the other one I did glue together so that we have it together like sometimes you find them. And those look nice. The seams are great on those. Didn't need to touch them or anything. The base is all set up. We've got the rock wall ready to go, ready to be painted. I can hang on to the bottom, spray that, detail it for the cave. And then we've got our base, which is glued together with the nice two tabs. And I'll paint that as one so that when I'm dry brushing and painting, I don't have two different, completely different tones of earth. Got our fire pit and all that stuff. So that is pretty sweet. It was super easy to assemble these. I did a little clamping to hold stuff together at certain points. But other than that, it was not difficult. It is a very beginner-friendly kit. I'm going to take the stuff over. I'm going to get the bear in paint. When I come back, we'll have it painted. We'll be in our detail session, and we'll work through. So I will see you all in just a moment. Thank you.
Thank you.
So there you have it, the awesome Atlantis prehistoric scenes snapped together 1/13th scale cave bear kit. Of course, we already checked out the saber-toothed tiger early in this video, and someday in the future, because they're going to be releasing more of these, now that I've got it built, I could always paint that up, but getting them both done in one video was a little much for the rush I'm in this holiday week. I've got stuff I need to do, I've got a new truck coming in, stuff, so I just wanted to get this done and let you guys enjoy it before the big holiday weekend. There will be no official build on Saturday, just letting you know that. It's a holiday weekend. Views are always super low anyways during the holiday weekends, and I have some cool stuff I want to get done this holiday and enjoy myself, so I might get a couple other videos done. Maybe we'll throw a tool review up or something, or just an unboxing or whatever, but just letting you guys know, nothing's wrong, nothing's going haywire or anything. I just didn't feel like spending time on another kit trying to get it done with the holiday in the middle of the week. So we got the cave bear done. It is an easy kit to assemble. It's a lot of fun. You can pose it any way you want. I've just got him pressed on that little stake there. I've got him kind of bent. From behind, he looks weird, but from the front, he looks like he's lunging in like he does on the back of the box art there. We've got the sign. I did not glue it to the model. I left it off. I think I wanted to take pictures without the sign in front of it and make it look, you know, quasi more realistic. This video is pretty much a lesson in dry brushing and how easy it is to dry brush and how easy it is to accentuate a figure kit and build them and not have it be overcomplicated to where it's not enjoyable. A lot of people worry about figure kits. They see these models, they want to build them, but they're worried that they can or can't do it. And you can. You can easily do a figure kit. Look at this. We've got groundwork. We've got body parts. We've got bone. We've got an animal with a full face and a grimace. And it doesn't take much work to get it done. Yes, if you wanted to, you could sand these seams and rescribe in all the little hairs and stuff on the neck, but that's not what this video is about. It's a simple build. It's showing how to use, you know, very inexpensive craft paints and detailing and enjoying yourself on a model. And this looks very competent on a shelf as it is. We didn't have to do any scribing, any sanding. We just built it as it is. And since we didn't buff out the joints and we didn't fill them with putty, you can always repose the figure as well. Move the head, change the angle of the arms, the legs, whatever you want to do. I have him as if he's kind of coming into the cave, because we can see this is the exterior of the cave. And then in real world, you know, there'd be more stuff around it. But he kind of ducks in because he's smelling that antelope egg that I, antelope leg that I stole from the Mr. Kitty kit. And I painted it up and put it by the fire as if the cavemen were having a fire. And I used real ash from my fire pit and just took out some of the bigger chunks that fell in. So, you know, there's little pieces left in there that look like little burnt out logs and stuff like that. And so he can smell that and he comes in to raid that and take that food. And so the Neanderthals or cavemen or whatever took off this way. Comes in, he sees the skulls of his friends. I mean, these are bear skulls. They gotta be. They definitely look like bear skulls. And he's like, roar. So now he's kind of upset, you know, and he kind of comes in with the angry grimace and he's ready to brawl, you know, with all the stuff in the cave. So I've got him with his nice pink gums and tongue and then his teeth. And then I stained his teeth a little bit because I've never seen a wild animal with pearly white teeth unless it was like a year old. They're always some sort of stained brown, tartar, you know, stuff like that. So I painted them white to begin with. Then I did the nails. And I did them with the tan and a little white. And then I put gloss coat inside the mouth, on the nose, and in the eyes to give them that alive look. The nails especially, because they're made out of keratin-like hair, so they have a little bit of shine to them. And he's stumbling in, and he's going to start going around. He's going to eat that antelope leg. Well, I keep calling it an egg. He's going to eat that up. And then he's going to go look and see if he can have some Neanderthals for dinner, because he's a big boy. I mean, I would anticipate that's fully grown adult. He is quite large. Look at that leg in 1/13 scale compared to him. So that's not going to be enough. That's just going to be like half a turkey drumstick for him. And the kit itself, being an old Aurora kit, you wouldn't think would have this much detail. But we've got stonework, two skulls. I left one intact and I left this one intact and I split the other two up like the bone pieces. We got that leg. Painted that with red gloss craft paint. Everything is craft paint, aside from where you saw me spray painting. Used the gloss coat in the bottle, glossed up the noses and stuff like that, got the nails down. And then I didn't do as strong of a shadowing as they did on the box art. You know, they really, with their airbrush and their mixing, really looks nice. A much darker nose, much darker underpaws. I did more of an American brown bear, where it's the brown with the lighter brown hair along the ridge on the back and on the belly and on the shoulders and the elbows. That's kind of what I did. So like the predecessor of an American grizzly bear is kind of what I wanted mine to look like when he's crawling into the cave and stuff like that. So the label says Europe. This would be more of a North American look to it, but they're very, very similar. You know, there's not much difference, you know, between them. And we got the inside. It's just such, I love the figure kits. I get so excited about them. So not to ramble, but I just enjoy it and I love looking at them and they don't take a lot of work. I want to encourage you guys to do it. Cheap craft paints, dry brushing. You see how nice everything turns out with just a little bit of work. Even the washes that I hand make out of craft paint lay on and give us the snarling creases in the nose and along the joints of the body where it would be a little darker where the light is. You can do all of it and enjoy yourself. So thanks for watching the workshop. Have a happy 4th. Make sure you are careful and save all 10 fingers if you still have all 10, because it's hard to build models with only 3 fingers. It really is. So I will see all of you at the next review.